G'day guys, how are you going? Hope you're all doing well. Just thought I'd show you the box art, as this will be my final video for the Ent kit. So I've seen it in my first video, but I just thought I'd show you the box art again. As you can see on the back here, compared to my kit, this one's a little bit more sparse in branches, especially on the arms. Much happier with the way that mine turned out. Let's have a look. Here's all the paints that I've used to paint the kit up with. And just at the front there, you can see it's a Winsor & Newton, and that is the titanium white from Winsor & Newton. Really love Winsor & Newton oils. Can't rate them high enough. I'll just get that out of the way just to show the rest of the colors I used. So this is pretty much my Ent finished up. I've got a little bit more on the groundwork to do, but this will more than likely be my last video I'm doing them, given that I've just finished painting the Ent itself, and just really a little bit more litter on the ground, and that'll be it. I've just pretty much done a couple more washes all over the kit, and I've added a bit of oil paint just to do a couple of small pin washes. I really only started this kit just to do a very quick kit in between kits, and I ended up getting a little bit more involved than I thought I was going to be doing this kit. And I actually really end up enjoying it. It was sort of quite refreshing having to do something with really very, very little parts, which sort of lets you get more involved in the actual painting. And because the kit wasn't complicated at all, it didn't really take very long to put together. Really only a couple of minutes, but then I did add an extra bit of putty just to cover up some of the joins in the model itself, and then just to add the bark. One of the things I enjoyed about this kit is once you start painting figures a lot with flesh tones and obviously armor and stuff like that, you get used to building or painting those sorts of vehicles and figures, and you sort of home in on those techniques. But something that I haven't really painted a lot of is trees and bark. So this was a real learning curve for me. But I still used a lot of the techniques in doing armor with sort of the washes and the pin washes and also doing figures using a lot of high and low lights in certain areas. So those two sort of skills in both areas sort of really came together, which I think really helped doing this Ent. I did end up giving this a spray of dull coat in the end because I just thought the bark still was a little bit too shiny for my liking. So I gave it one or two coats of dull coat just to really tone the sheen of the bark down. The last thing I'll do will be just to run a bit of future gloss in a couple of places over the leaves, just to give them a little bit of shine, and also give another coat just to the eyes, just to have them a bit shinier than they are because of the dull coat. Other thing I liked adding is just a couple extra branches on the back of it from the kit, and I was very happy to find out that they came in the kit, the extra head, so that really helped me add a few more branches to the back there. And obviously just gouging out the face of the other head was quite easy because it didn't have to be perfectly smooth or anything like that. As you can see here, hopefully you can still see I've added a little bit of branches or vines on the ground there. And I've really just colored that the same as the tree just to give it a bit of a forest feeling, and it's come alive, as I've said in one of my other videos. And I've just sort of ran that over the figure as well, just like it's sort of dragging it away a bit. I didn't spend too much time on the figure, and I sort of tried to color it a bit like the base because I didn't really want the figure on the ground to be the standout and for your eyes to go to that. I was really wanting it to just focus on the actual Ent itself. And I hadn't really sculpted much bark before, so I thought this was a nice, reasonably easy kit to try it out on. Some bits of the bark texture turned out a bit nicer than some of the other bits I'd done. I really like this bit on the forearm, if you like. I think it's probably one of my favorite parts I did. And probably just a little bit different was this little wraparound bit of bark up here on his upper arm. I've sort of seen plenty of trees or paper bark trees or branches that sort of have that sort of loose bark falling off, especially if you get firewood sometimes. You sort of notice a bit of the bark sort of actually coming off the actual tree itself. Anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed this little look at my Ent. I think in the end, adding a little bit more bark and the extra branches, I think really improved this kit quite a lot. I think the original kit is a little bit sparse in the way of branches and maybe just a little bit of detail. So I think just going and adding just a little bit more, which was very basic to do, I think really added a little bit more interest and texture to this kit. Be on to my next model very shortly. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.